This could be us. So back to what I was saying. This could be us.
Hello everyone and welcome to Palatech Gaming. My name is Anthony and today I'm going to show you how you can overclock your graphics card the easy way and make it run at a higher frequency than normal in order to increase its performance and get more FPS in your games with the help of MSI Afterburner. I am also going to show you how to set up MSI Afterburner on-screen display so that you can monitor your FPS and much more. So, without further delay, let's go to Google and type MSI Afterburner in the search box. Then click on the first result that comes up, which will take you to MSI Afterburner's website, and then click on the Download Afterburner button. As soon as the download ends, double-click on the zip file and then double-click on the MSI Afterburner setup file. Then click OK, Next, or Install on any prompts that follow after that to complete the installation. Once MSI Afterburner's main window appears on screen, click on the cog icon that will open Settings. Click the on-screen display tab and then click the More button, and this will open the Riva Tuner Statistics Server window. Make sure that both the Show On-Screen Display and Show On Statistics toggles are both on. The on-screen display zoom slider allows you to set the size of the text displayed on the screen. After that, close the Riva Tuner window, click Apply, and then click the Monitoring tab. You must tick all the properties you want in your OSD and also tick the Show in On-Screen Display checkbox for each item you want to be displayed. The essential properties you need to tick are GPU temperature, GPU usage, memory usage, core clock, memory clock. Power consumption is quite useful to display as well. Fan speed, CPU temperature, all CPU usage properties in order to monitor how many threads are used at any given time and what's the overall CPU usage. CPU clock, RAM usage, and of course, frame rate that we need to set to display both text and graph, and the same goes for frame time as well. You can also choose to display minimum, maximum and average frame rates, as well as 1% lows and 0.1% lows depending on your preference. Then click Apply and OK. After that, our setup is practically complete and we can start using MSI Afterburner to monitor our hardware and overclock our GPU. For our test, we are going to run Kenna Bridge of Spirits. we are running the game at 1080p Ultra Graphics preset, as you can see in the game settings. Our GPU is running at stock clocks, which is 1848 MHz for the core clock and 4 GHz for the memory clock. And the game is running at 34 to 35 FPS with these settings. Now let's minimize the game and use MSI Afterburner to overclock our GPU. The GPU can be overclocked either by using the core clock and the memory clock sliders, or by dialing in the exact overclock values we want. In this case, we set the core clock at plus 200 MHz and the memory clock at plus 400 MHz. The core clock is now around 2 GHz, the memory clock is 4.4 GHz, and the game is now running at 43 FPS with the same settings as before. As you can see in the game settings, we are still running the game at 1080p Ultra Graphics preset, and our FPS has increased around 26%. Now, if we reset the clocks at their stock values, our FPS dropped back to 35, exactly as they were before the overclock. When we are overclocking, it is best to do so in small increments. Like, for example, 30 MHz at a time to test the stability of our overclock and slowly progress upwards till we start having stability issues. Always monitor your temperatures and make sure that the GPU remains below 84 to 85 degrees under full load. If the GPU temperature exceeds 85 degrees, then you can either increase the GPU fan speed so that the temperature drops, or dial down your overclock even if it's stable so that the heat won't damage your graphics card in the long term. And with that said, we have reached the end of our GPU overclocking guide. If you liked this video and found it useful, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel. Hope to see you in our next video. Thanks for watching.